I want to start by reading out of the Gospel of John, chapter 9, verses 35 through 41. And Jesus heard that they had cast him out. And when he had found him, he said unto him, Doest thou believe on the Son of God? He answered and said, Who is he, Lord, that I might believe on him? And Jesus said unto him, Thou hast both seen him, and it is he that talketh with thee. And he said, Lord, I believe, and he worshipped him. And Jesus said, For judgment I am come into the world, that they which see not might see, and they that which see might be made blind. And some of the Pharisees which were with him heard these words and said unto him, Are we blind also? And Jesus said unto them, If ye were blind, you would have no sin. But now ye say, We see, therefore your sin remaineth. Father God, I thank you for this opportunity to preach to your wonderful people, Lord. I thank you for this wonderful day that you've given us, Lord. Lord, I ask you, Lord, to anoint my mouth so that I may speak your word. And humble me, Lord, so that I may speak it humbly. You send your Holy Spirit to speak these words, your words, Lord, because only you speak them with authority. We thank you and we praise you. I pray that you anoint their ears to hear and their eyes to see what your word means, Lord, and what your word says. For your word says, I can water, somebody else can plant, but only you, Lord, can give the increase. In the holy name of Jesus, I pray for increase today. In the blessed name of Jesus, I pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Basically, what was going on is Jesus just had opened a man's eyes that had been blind since his birth. And the Pharisees saw this. And They were basically, if you use today's terminology, they were hating on this man. And they asked him, who did this? And he said, I know not his name. And they kicked him out of the temple. And then when Jesus heard that he was kicked out of the temple, Jesus went to him. And Jesus said, Doest thou believe on the Son of God? And the man, he said, well, who is he? Where is he? Where is he? Show me him so that I may see him and I may worship him. And Jesus said that he is that one. And the man fell down and he worshiped Jesus, because Jesus was the one that healed his eyes. Jesus was the one that showed him amazing grace. How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found, but blind, and now I see. Hallelujah. Jesus opened his eyes and Jesus closed the eyes of the Pharisees, because the Pharisees were the one that were thinking that they had all the answers. They were the most holy of holies, they thought. They thought they were righteous. That's the problem with today's generation. They're holier than thou. They're holier than thou. Self-righteousness is the biggest sin of all. Because once you reach the point of self-righteousness, you lose your humility and your pride starts to grow. And you start thinking that you don't need Jesus anymore. You start thinking that you're doing all these things on your own. When you prosper, you think you're doing it on your own. When you start seeing spiritual things, you start thinking that you did it on your own. And that's what the problem with the Pharisees were. They were holier than thou. They were self-righteous, hallelujah. And Jesus, he cut them down a notch. As you can see in the next chapter, Jesus told them all that the problems that they were having spiritually and physically that they were not pleasing God anymore because they shut off the kingdom to all the people, and they made it hard for the people to enter the kingdom of God, and they made it hard for themselves to enter the kingdom of God, and God made them blind. That God made them spiritually blind. Hallelujah. And He opened the eyes of the poor. He opened the eyes of the meek. He opened the eyes of all the ones that were humbling themselves. He opened their eyes. And that's how the Gentiles, us Gentiles, got the gospel. Because back in the day, the Jews weren't sharing the holy things to the Gentiles. They weren't sharing God's word to the Gentiles. The Gentiles, they were going on about their merry way and doing their thing and worshiping idols. And then the Jews started worshiping the idols. But if they had shared that God's word with the Gentiles, there might have been more that God could have saved. Hallelujah. But let me tell you, when Jesus came down from heaven, from the right hand of God, He stepped down from His throne and He came to this world and He came to show us the glory of God. He came to show us how much God loves us, that He would send His only begotten Son to die on that cross. When He was on that cross, He said, "It's finished. It is done." Hallelujah. And He closed the eyes of the ones that were self-righteous, and He opened the eyes of the meek and the humble. He made that blind man to see, both physically and spiritually, and completely. This guy, this man, he was healed in the name of Jesus. Jesus still heals today. And He's got so many people that doubt the healing of Jesus. They go here and they go there. But rather than going to prayer, rather than asking a pastor to lay hands, rather than asking a pastor to help them to see, they go to other people. And it's so many times, beloved, that I see that so many people are starting to go to these psychics and these tarot readers. They go to these people and they read the horoscopes, and they're blind. Why are they blind? Because they don't want to see. Jesus showed me that. When Jesus gives me revelation, when nobody around me is getting the same revelation, it's not because He's not sharing it with them. It's because they choose not to see. They choose to be blind. They don't want to see reality. They don't want to see God's glory. They think they see God's glory, and then God's glory is hid from them because they refuse to see that Jesus still heals today. Jesus still opens the eyes of the blind so that they may see. He still unstops their ears so that they can hear. I pray, Lord, open their eyes so that they can see. Open their ears so that they can hear. It's just like in the story of Elijah. When Elijah and his servant was walking, and then all of a sudden the servant saw all of the army surrounding them, and the servant started getting scared. And Elijah seen something that he didn't see because his eyes were open, because he chose for his eyes to be open. He chose to see these things. Hallelujah. And then when the servant come to Elijah and started talking about how scared he was, Elijah told him not to fear anything. And he asked the Lord to open his servant's eyes so that his servant could see what he sees. And as soon as the Lord granted him that request, the Lord opened his eyes, and the servant saw legions of angels surrounding them and protecting them from these people that were coming upon them. And the servant lost his fear. Where there is no vision, the people perish, saith the Lord. Open your eyes. Start requesting. Start honoring and start asking the Lord for revelation. Start asking the Lord for vision. Open your spiritual eyes. This is how you do it. You ask the Lord, please, Lord, show me spiritual things so that I can look past the physical things. Because the physical things aren't real to me. And I asked Jesus, and Jesus showed me that there's a reason why he is more real than anybody else to me. Because I choose to see Jesus as being more real than anybody I've ever seen, more real than anything I've ever heard, is the gospel of Jesus Christ. It's real, and it's alive, and it's here. So open your eyes, open your ears to the word, to the revelation of Jesus Christ. Don't be like the Pharisees walking around think that you already know it all. Because I'm telling you, we could go through eternity asking the Lord to show us revelation. He could give us revelation every second, and we'd still go all through eternity learning something new. It's just like that. The Lord Jesus Christ, he pulls you to the side and he says, let me show you, my child, let me show you something new. Let me show you new vision. Let me show you new revelation. Let me show you how it is. Let me show you the reality of things. Let me show you how to look past the physical, past the natural, into the supernatural. Let me give you word of wisdom. Let me give you word of knowledge, saith the Lord. Open your eyes. Open your ears. Let me in. I'm knocking at the door. Let him in, beloved. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's the revelation that you get from this story, is that the Pharisees didn't want to let him in. The Pharisees didn't want new revelation or vision. They wanted to keep their old vision. They wanted to keep their old traditions. And that's what's going on in the world today. All completely. You have man traditions. There's nothing wrong with celebrating Christmas. There's nothing wrong with celebrating Easter. There's nothing wrong with celebrating Thanksgiving. But let me tell you, the devil has corrupted these days. No, Jesus wasn't born in December, but it's okay to celebrate his birthday in December. But what has the devil done? He's closed the eyes of the Christian church. And the Christian church is talking about Santa Claus. They're talking about Christmas trees. They're not talking about the birth of Jesus. Easter, Resurrection Sunday. There's nothing wrong with celebrating Easter, but what has the devil done? He's brought in a little pretty bunny rabbit, and everybody starts talking about the Easter bunny. They're not talking about the resurrection of Jesus Christ. The church has lost its vision. The church has become blind. It's time to wake your eyes up. It's time for fresh vision. It's time for fresh revelation in Jesus' name. We glory your name, Lord, and we ask you each and every day to show us something new, show us something exciting, show us something through eternity, show us everything that you need us to know. Show us, and don't let our revelations go sour. Don't let our visions go stagnant like old water. The living water flows, but when you stop the flow, it starts going stagnant. You got to keep the river flowing. You got to keep the stream going. The water has to keep moving. That revelation has to keep coming. And I'm telling you, you have to forget about all of these man-made things and start worshiping God. Start worshiping God in spirit. Start worshiping God in truth. Because that's what Jesus said. Jesus said God is a spirit, and he must be worshiped in spirit and in truth. There's no other way about it. There's no other way around it. You have to worship him in spirit. You have to worship him in truth, because Jesus said he must be worshiped that way. And that's the way he prefers to be worshiped, through the spirit, not through the flesh. See, that's the problem with the Pharisees. They were worshiping God with their flesh. They were telling the people to do this. And then they were doing something else. And then the people saw the Pharisees doing these evil things, and they started doing these evil things. Don't put your trust in any man. Put your trust in Jesus. Put your trust in the Lord completely and entirely. That's what it's all about. That's what Jesus is asking. He's asking you to come into the kingdom and to live each and every day to please God. To please God in the spirit. You can't please God in the flesh. You cannot please God by doing it your way. You have to do it Jesus' way. What did Jesus say? I am the truth. I am the life. Nobody goes to the Father but by me. And I'm telling you, there's so many people think there's other different ways. They worship a different Jesus. They worship a different God. They pray to a different God. Because Jesus said it had to be this way. There's no other path. There's no other way. You have to go down the right path. When you start going down your own path, you start leading away from God. You start walking away from His righteousness. You start walking down the road that the world is going down. And that is the broad way to destruction, beloved. It's time to wake up. I pray in the name of Jesus. I speak it with authority. Wake up and start realizing what the real world's about. It's about God. There's nothing else but God. There's nothing else to worship. It's all a part of God's plan to wake you up. He wills that none perish. He wills that all come to salvation. But you have to be willing to see that revelation. You have to be willing to open your spiritual eyes and to see what it's really about. And God is what it's really about. It's not about Santa Claus. It's not about the Easter Bunny. It's not about any of this other stuff. It's about God and what He did for you. You can't do it on your own. You can't reach salvation on your own. You have to have Jesus. Jesus is the key. Jesus is the key to the Father. Jesus is the key to a prosperous eternity. Eternity with God forever and ever. Oh, there's another path that you can take that the 99% of the world is going down. And that's that broad path, that broad way. And it leads only one place, to destruction, beloved. God's lovely people, open your spiritual eyes. Stop this silliness. Stop this man-made stuff. Stop this man-made tradition. It's all about what God did for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Watch out now. I'm preaching today. I'm preaching to you today. There's somebody out there that's hearing this for the first time. And they're praising God right now because they just got that revelation of what God did for them on Calvary's cross. Hallelujah. 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 I'm telling you, beloved. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, beloved, God is expanding this ministry. Every Monday morning, Eastern Standard Time, on my YouTube channel, the ministry YouTube channel, youtube.com/international ministry. I'm starting to do a prayer call every Monday morning. And I pray that each and every one of you come. What you're going to do is you're going to come in and you're going to type in your prayer request. And you pray for everybody else's prayer request. We're all praying. We're all standing in agreement. Because Acts chapter 2 says they were all in one accord. In one place. Hallelujah. We're all going to be every Monday morning. We're all going to be at one accord. In one place. Hallelujah. And we're going to pray these prayers for these saints. It's time to stop suffering. It's time to stop being confused, for Jesus is not the author of confusion. Hallelujah. Join us each Monday morning. Each Monday morning on YouTube. It's live and it's free. Hallelujah. All you got to do is be there. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, we ask you, Lord. We thank you for this opportunity. We pray for fresh vision. We pray for fresh revelation. In Jesus' name, open their eyes. Open their ears so that they see past the physical. In the blessed name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. I thank you all for listening, beloved. And I pray that each and every one of you have a blessed, blessed day.
All right, beloved. It's time for the sinner's prayer. Repeat after me and believe in your heart that what Jesus says is true. Hebrews 6:18 says it's impossible for God to lie. And he said, he who asketh receiveth. And well, today we're going to ask Jesus to save you. In the name of Jesus, repeat after me. Father God in heaven, I come to you today a sinner. I ask you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, to save me from my sins. Come into my heart. I believe everything you said. I believe all of your words. I come to you, Lord, in repentance. Wash me clean. Make me free. Because your word says, who Jesus sets free is free indeed. I believe those words. And I believe you're saving me today, Lord. I ask for a fresh outpouring of the Holy Spirit today, a fresh outpouring of the anointing that you give all believers. I want to join you in heaven. I want to repent of my sins. I want you to save me, Lord. Show me where I need to repent. Show me where I need to change. I believe you, Lord, and I thank you in advance. In the name of Jesus, I speak things that aren't as if though they already were. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. If you said that prayer, you're on your way to being saved. Believe everything Jesus says. Every word that's in the Bible is true. And if you said that prayer and you know that you know that you know that it's true, today you've started your path on the right path, on the narrow way. In the name of Jesus, amen and amen. Hallelujah.